Are you ready to move forward with your entrepreneurial dreams? Starting or building a business is not for everyone, but if you have the drive and passion to make a difference in the world, then being an entrepreneur is a great way for you to make a dent in the universe. I'm David Mammano, a 7-time successful serial entrepreneur, and I am ready to help you. At Avanti Entrepreneur TV, I will interview some of the most successful business owners of our time. The goal is to get you the knowledge and inspiration you need so that you can bring your entrepreneurial dreams to the next level. Avanti means move forward in Italian, and that's exactly what you will do when you watch Avanti Entrepreneur TV. Hi, I'm Dave Mammano, host of the Avanti Entrepreneur Show, and I am so excited to have a guest today. My guest today is Stephanie Armstrong. Stephanie, how are you doing today?
I'm fantastic, because I'm with you.
I appreciate that. So, Stephanie is she's a relatively new friend. When did we meet? How long ago?
Just a few months ago.
Right?
Yeah. Through Facebook.
Through Facebook.
We found each other on the Facebook.
Through the Facebook. Maybe we'll give Tony D'Agostino some credit,
yes,
right?
Yes, he'll love
so,
that.
So, Tony, our mutual friend. So, but Stephanie owns a company called BiQi, which is kind of, and she'll tell you why, but so she is a digital marketing and just probably, I'll say, marketing specialist overall, but super hyper special when it comes to digital marketing.
Yes, that right? is my favorite.
So tell us, if you don't mind, give us an overview of what you do, what makes you special and unique, because there's a lot of people out there saying they're digital marketing specialists today, right? And what is BiQi?
Yeah, so BiQi is this, you know, it's a really new approach to marketing. Mm-hmm. So my background, my professional background is in broadcast. So, you know, I worked for some of the television stations and I learned a lot about what has worked over the last few decades, which is what I would like refer to as direct response type of marketing. Like, you know, you got a big red tent sale, you got a wacky inflatable arm guy, you know, you got a Labor Day sale, but it's always very like business focused. It's always very, you know, sale focused, price point focused. And at some point I was just like, no one wants this anymore. Like it's played out. You know, like what else can we do here? So when digital really started to grow, which when I was first really involved in marketing, it didn't really exist very much. I think we had like banner ads right. that we could offer businesses.
That nobody ever clicked on.
That no one wanted.
Yeah. And they weren't targeted at all.
They retargeted them, right?
Yeah.
You know, it was not very effective. So when digital really started to become an option, I was like, you know, what can we do with this that's different? That's a different approach. Because especially when you look at millennials, that type of advertising really just doesn't work.
Right.
So what's interesting is my educational background is in psychology. And my whole, you know, marketing career, I was like, I wasted my time in school.
Right.
You know, I have this psychology degree that's just like pointless.
But it's not.
Not anymore. So now I get into digital and it's a completely different approach. Like what really, really works with digital is really connecting with your consumer and really understanding what they want and really understanding what their problem is and developing a relationship with them and building trust and building rapport and building a brand and community that people love to purchase from. So that's a completely different approach, right, than like, I've got a sale this weekend or just trying to like out-brand your competitor.
Right.
It's a very different approach, but when you go this way, you have more long-lasting relationships with your consumers who buy more and can't wait to tell all their friends about you.
Right.
So our approach, we would say that we're a consumer-focused digital marketing company and we're a holistic digital marketing company with a specialty in social media. And what I mean by that is we might handle your social media, but we're also going to be working with our team to help with your website updates, you know, to help with your search engine optimization to make sure that you rank well with Google, to help maybe with your business listings online to make sure that information is current and updated and people can find you, to help you develop content for people to engage with, you know, like this is what we're doing right now. This is content, right?
Right. Yeah.
So really from start to finish, what we're really trying to do is develop a strategy that engages your ideal consumer, you know, that builds a relationship with them and that leads to them doing business with you. I always say like, you know, if the relationship is there, the business just comes.
Right. The know, like, and trust funnel.
Absolutely. Yep. When you talk about social, like, there's no better place to do that than social media, than to really start developing those relationships.
Well, what's nice is what I'm hearing is, especially with your psychology degree, is you can dig deeper. You can really find out, you know, before you launch an advertising campaign that sometimes in the past was based on trial and error, you could get more quote unquote ammunition so that you know how to target, like, what they want. First of all, what do they want product wise, and then how do they want to hear about it? What's gonna make them excited about learning more about that product?
Absolutely.
Right? You know, and the results. Like, what are the results that they're gonna get if they get this product? And it's a little bit more effective than the, what'd you call it, the balloon for the car dealership?
The direct response.
Right.
Wacky inflatable arm guy.
The wacky inflatable arm guy. So I was in broadcast as well. I was in radio sales before I started my companies here. And, you know, we used to have this saying, I think it was from Wrigley, you know, Mr. Wrigley Gum, that he would say, 50% of the advertising didn't work and 50% worked. He just didn't know which was which. Right? So then he would have to continue to spend, you know, his big investment, but he couldn't track it, right? He knew it was working, some wasn't working, but he couldn't track it. Now in today's world, you don't have to waste, right? You could, I mean, maybe in the beginning you're testing some things out, you know, and maybe you could say that's more research than waste, but then you could really hone it to target and get really specific results and feedback.
That's what I love about digital. So, you know, I worked with clients when I was in broadcast, I mean, who were literally spending hundreds of thousands of dollars with me a month and not getting results, you know, not getting results. And what could I tell them?
Right.
You know, there was really nothing I could tell them. And although, you know, there's a lot of people that get into that business, you know, just to make money, that didn't feel good to me because I love to build businesses.
Yeah.
You know, I really enjoy helping good people build their vision.
Yeah.
So with the data that we have from digital, everything's tracked, everything's measured, and there's so much out there now that we can take a look at and figure out really, you know, a business owner might think, I think, you know, our key demographic is 25 to 54. So that's a really common demographic right in broadcast.
Right. Yeah.
But when I run your ad campaigns, I might find out that you have a really low cost with people from women from 35 to 44, that's actually really where your sweet spot is because I can look at the data and I can analyze that.
It's your super niche, right?
Yeah. Then I can optimize it to make sure that your ads are hyper-focused on those people. And what that's going to allow you to do is get way more results for way less money.
Right.
So it works out. Yeah. For everyone, it just really, really works out.
Yeah.
In addition, you can follow people through this buying cycle. So we talk a lot about the consumer buying journey and what does that look like? You know, we talk about the first step is really awareness. People have to know that you exist for them to first, you know, look into you at all.
Right. Yeah.
So first is awareness. Then they need to consider you. Like, how do you communicate your solution to them? And then they need to be able to convert some way, somehow they have to be able to contact you.
Yeah.
So social is an amazing tool for hyper-targeting. You know, you really can't target any better than you can through the social media platforms to get the awareness out there. And it's the least expensive way to stay in front of your audience.
Right.
In marketing, we always talk about a cost per thousand, right? So, you know, television, it's not uncommon to pay $30, $40, $50 to hit 1,000 people, but on social media, you might be able to do that for $2, $3, $4.
Right.
So you can really get in front of a ton of people.
And more engagement opportunities, too.
Yeah.
It's hard to click on the TV, right?
You can't, right? This creates an opportunity for dialogue. It creates an opportunity for feedback. And that's really what makes this relationship work, where people really feel like they're engaged with you.
Yeah.
And while 5 years ago, people kind of looked at me like I was crazy when I was talking about Facebook marketing for business, you know, now what we're seeing is that people that have the opportunity to engage with brands on social media, they often spend up to 60% more with those companies.
Wow.
Because they really feel like they have a relationship with them. So this is really an incredible opportunity to get in front of people, stay in front of people, build that relationship up, and build a community where people are excited to purchase your products and tell everybody about them.
Avanti, friends, wicked smart. Wicked smart over here, I'm telling you. And now I'm going to ask you the question you've been waiting for, okay? So, Stephanie, so a lot of our Avanti friends here are beginning to middle stage entrepreneurs.
Got it.
As you approach, you know, prospects, customers, start working with them,
What are the top five mistakes that you see businesses who are not doing social media or digital marketing at all, what are the top five mistakes that they're making?
The first one is definitely just that they're resistant to it. You know, I understand that it's new. You know, the internet kind of was a thing when I was a teenager, so I get that it's still new. And it's like, a lot of people would hate to admit this, but it can be a little intimidating because it's not as easy to understand as, you know, you've got an ad on page 6A or your, you know, your TV commercial will run at 6:47. You know, it's a little intangible. So the first mistake that I see is they're just resistant to it. They're not doing it. The reality is, over the next 5 to 10 years, the vast majority of the business that we do will take place online. I mean, right now what we're seeing is 80% of purchases are first influenced by something that happens online.
Sure.
And absolutely, that's where they're going when they have an idea. So the first thing is that they're resisting it. Their website isn't up to date. You know, they don't have a presence on social media. They're not producing content for their business. They're just resisting it. And a lot of times I would say this is because they're not confident about pursuing it, and they don't know exactly, you know, how to go about doing it. But it is, you have to kind of get on that now. It's time.
It's time.
It's time. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You really got it. So right. The first thing is that they're resisting it.
Yeah. So number one, they're resisting it.
Yeah. The second thing is that it's piecemealed. So I go in and I talk to a lot of businesses, a lot of very well-respected businesses. And I say, well, you know, who's handling your SEO? Oh, well, Joe handles the SEO. Okay. Who's handling your SEM? Oh, well, Mike handles the SEM. Did Joe and Mike ever talk? Mm. I don't think they know each other.
It's like the CIA and the FBI. They're not talking.
Right. We have a problem.
We have a problem. Yeah.
You know, because a lot of these things, you can look at the data from one form, you know, and figure out how you can apply that on another platform.
Yeah.
So a lot of times the other thing is that everything will be piecemealed, you know, like, well, the admin girl, she handles the Facebook page, you know, and Joe handles the SEO and Mike handles the SEM.
Right.
And there's no,
you probably don't want the admin girl handling it, right? Handling anything, right? Except maybe some admin, right?
Just, you know, so it's piecemealed, and when it's piecemealed, you're losing a ton of money. Like, you're just losing a lot of effectiveness.
It's just not all funneled in the same direction.
Because it's not working the same way.
Yeah.
So when we talk about, again, going back to that consumer buying journey, awareness, consideration, conversion. Awareness typically happens on Facebook. You know, if no one's ever heard of you, or on social media in general, if no one's ever heard of you, they're not doing a Google search for you because they don't know you exist.
Right.
But the search engines are going to take care of that consideration phase. So when they're actually ready to make a purchase, so you need flooring, right, for your house, and you're ready to make a purchase, you go into Google and you type either flooring near me, flooring in Victor, flooring, or you type in some of your favorite brands. You might type in Christian Flooring. You might type in Rochester Linoleum. You know, you might type in a brand that you know. But you have to make sure that whether the consumer is on social media or a search engine or your website, that they have a very similar experience no matter where they are at, so that they can continue to take action with you. So that piecemeal approach is very ineffective in that they're losing a lot of money just in the effectiveness of it.
Right.
And they're probably dropping people along the way because they're not just aware of this consumer buying journey.
Right. So focus it and funnel it in the right direction.
Yes.
Yeah.
Pay attention to that.
Yeah,
so that's probably the second thing that I see that I know is creating a big problem.
Cool. You got three more?
I think I got three more.
All right, good.
The third one is that they focus too much on themselves.
Oh, I'm probably guilty of it, but I know what you mean, right?
You know, it's just a different time. You know, you can't really talk about the car that you sell anymore because no one cares.
Right.
All of your competitors have the same cars, right? Like, we live in a world now where there's a lot less, you know, differentiation in your product or service. There's, you know, a lot of people can go and they can get digital marketing from anywhere, right? Like, they could call anyone. What is it about us that makes it different? The first thing is that we really understand our consumer. Like, we spend a lot of time in the human behavior realm and really understanding, like, what's going on with entrepreneurs? What's going on with small business owners? What are their challenges? And then we speak to those things. We see too many businesses that are, like, product and service specific. Like, that's all that they're talking about. And that's not really what your consumer is looking for. It's like if you went on a date, right? You take your wife to dinner and you're like, hi, I'm David. And here's where I went to school. And here's all of my accomplishments.
Right,
and here's all the, I'm a great cook.
Here's why I'm
so
wonderful.
Great jokes.
Right.
Your wife's going to look at you and be like, that's really great, but like, how does that apply to me?
Right.
Right? And we have to start thinking of it that way.
Right.
How can we tell the consumer?
What everybody's favorite radio station is WIIFM. What's in it for me?
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. So we have to like really be able to talk to like what their challenges are, what their problems are. Sometimes it might not at all be related. For example, what's your favorite thing that I do on my social media?
Oh, I love your Mindful Mondays.
Mindful Mondays. Yeah. Now, does mindfulness have anything to do with marketing?
Not to my knowledge.
Not very much.
Not to my knowledge. Yeah. But it makes me put you like, you know, I look forward to it. So I'm thinking about you Monday morning.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it builds a relationship, right?
Yeah.
You start to get to know who I am as a person.
Yeah.
It shares my values.
Yeah.
Like you'll know right away, like it's not just a business for me.
Would you be mad if I competed with you and had Mammano Mondays?
You can have Mammano Mondays. Yeah. I might jump in.
You can be at it.
Show up.
You can be at it. Absolutely.
Yeah, but just creating content that your audience really is looking for. It may not have anything to do with your business. So that's the part that we have to like let go of is like my Mindful Mondays have nothing to do with marketing at all, but it really helps me build a relationship with my consumer and it helps me share my values and like who I am as a person.
Yeah.
And then the right people are attracted, right? Like if you're
not really
into that.
You're helping people.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that would be, what's that? Is that the third one?
That's the third one, yeah.
The third one, all right.
How about two more?
The fourth one is they spread their budget too thin.
Mm.
They
spray and pray. They spray and pray, right?
Yeah, they're like, okay, here's my really excited ones. All right, like I really want to do this social media thing. Like I know I need it for my business. I want to be on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, YouTube, Snapchat, Pinterest. I got $1,000 a month.
Right. I want to be on eBay. Like they don't even know what they're talking about.
Right. I'm, you know, producing content and making the strategy effective is time consuming.
It really,
like if you have to go do it yourself, you'll find out really quick that to put out really good high quality content that really engages with your audience and look at the data and figure out which pieces do the best.
Yeah.
It's time consuming. It takes a lot of time to do it well. The people that do it well, you're just like, oh, this looks so easy. Anyone could, but then you get into it and you find out like it's a little harder than you thought.
Right. Yeah.
So don't spread your budget too thin. You know, if you only have $1,000 or $1,500 a month to invest, pick one platform that makes the most sense for you and own it. Like do really, really well with it. Because what'll happen is you'll bring in enough return on investment that at some point you'll have another budget for the next platform.
Right. Yeah.
But if you spread it too thin, you're never going to get any traction on any of them. And then you're just kind of left. Then that's when I hear, social media doesn't work.
Right.
And I'm like, well, what did you do?
You can say social media works. Sometimes the people planning social media don't work.
Exactly.
But not you. You like that one?
I like it. I'm going to steal it. You're going to make Mammano Monday. And I'm
Mammano Monday. Would you watch Mammano Monday? Let me know.
Totally. And the last thing is, I think it's just this old school way of just going right for the sale. And I do make a lot of analogies back to relationships, but I think that's how we have to think about it. You know, I'm like, you know, would you just walk up to the cute girl at the bar and be like, hey, I'm David, I'd like to marry you?
That's what I was doing. That's what, my God, I wish I met you in college.
Hey, I'm David. How do you feel about getting married?
Yeah.
Like 2.5 kids, like, what's up?
Yeah. Now I know. Thank you for that.
You know, so it's like, if you wouldn't do that in real life, like, why are you doing that with your business?
And right. Like, it's a dance. It's a dance, right?
It is. And it's like, you know, build a relationship up with them. Too many people they want to go straight to the sale and they don't want to invest in building the relationship. But the real money is in the relationship. Like any successful business owner will tell you the big reason that they're so successful is because they have a series of repeat customers.
Yeah.
That love them and keep coming back and telling everyone about them.
Right.
So instead of just, you know, if you're using digital media, instead of just going right promoting a sale, instead what we do is we promote, hey, I've got something to give you. So it could be an ebook, you know, it could be a white paper. Yep. It's gonna be something that benefits them. So like one of the pieces that we have, you've seen it, is, you know, 5 ways to boost your social media engagement.
Yeah.
And that's a free resource that we offer to everybody.
Yeah.
But when you start with that, people are really inclined to start a relationship with you because you're giving first.
Right.
And that's what we talk about.
Yeah.
You know, from a marketing perspective, you have to give first. Give your consumer something that's really valuable to them, that really empowers them. And if you can empower them and educate them through the buying cycle, then the purchase comes so naturally, so easy. You stop fighting for sales. All of a sudden you have inbound leads coming in where people are calling you and they want your product or service, and you're not out beating the streets trying to get people to purchase. It's a completely different
approach. The cold calling goes away and people are calling you.
Exactly.
Yeah? Because you're offering value.
Right.
Yeah, I put a quote today on Facebook from Napoleon Hill. Mm-hmm. In order to get rich, first you have to enrich. Mm-hmm. And getting rich can not only mean money, it could mean a lot of different things. It could mean enriching your soul, enriching your mind. Yeah. And before you do that, you have to commit to give value, either value to other people, value to doing the tough work to enrich your mind, etc. And I see that totally with what you're doing. Like, no, come to my site. We have free, great value. Mm-hmm. And then they watch Mindful Monday.
Yeah.
And they're like, I want to work with Stephanie.
They're like, she's pretty cool. She seems a little bit like a hippie, and she's got some tattoos. Yeah. But I think she's all right.
She's one of these creatives, right?
Yeah. Just, you know, she doesn't live in a box.
I can assure you, she's very modest. She's, like I said, I'm going to say it again, she's wicked smart. Very wicked smart.
Thank you.
I'm not worthy.
Just maybe we all have.
I am just a caveman, right?
You already know.
So, Stephanie, I want to thank you so much for being on the Avanti Entrepreneur TV show.
You're very welcome.
And how people want to get in touch with you? How can they get in touch with you?
Yeah, please visit us online at BiQi Marketing. It's B as in boy, I-Q-I, marketing.com. We are on like pretty much every social media platform. So you can find us on Facebook, on Instagram, on YouTube. All BiQi Marketing, BiQi.
You can find her on eBay, whatever you want.
Is
she's
that
there.
Still a thing?
Friendster. Just kidding. So, and if you do want to you get in touch with her, you can throw me an email, david@davidmammano.com, and I'll connect you personally. So, thanks again, Stephanie. You're the best.
Thank you.
Boom. Thank you, Avanti. And thanks for watching another episode, and come back soon for some more episodes. Have a great one, and stay awesome.